You might have seen or heard of the app Clubhouse in the past few weeks or months, as people grow large followings and the likes of Elon Musk join a Clubhouse conversation for a few hours. What if I told you that you could create your very own Clubhouse using Riverside.fm?
Wait, what?
In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how. If you don't know what Clubhouse is, it's an invite-only social app. I have 5 invites if you'd like to check it out. Subscribe and leave a comment below if you want one of those, where people hold live audio-only conversations in a club. People can dial in or raise their hand to join the conversation, which can sometimes last for a few hours. Then once the show goes off air, it's finished. Now, Clubhouse is trending at the moment, and for good reason. People love live audio conversations that they can interact with. It's only going to keep growing and growing, which means you can build a following within the Clubhouse platform. The downside of building your following within Clubhouse is that you're then at the mercy of the app to make changes that could affect your following. We've seen this with Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, where followings become less valuable as the algorithm changes. With Riverside.fm, you can own your audience on an email list and let them know every time you go live with your Clubhouse style event. Riverside then allows you to take your live stream with video if you like and turn the high quality recording into a podcast. You can then use a platform like Luma to host all of your events, create a nice landing page and manage all of your subscribers. So head to your dashboard and click create new show. You're going to want to name this the name of your Clubhouse style event. I'm going to call it Riverside YouTube Clubhouse. I then need to make sure it's a live show. Select this to get that authentic Clubhouse audio only podcast style live stream. I'm going to click audio only, and this will only record the audio. If you did want to do audio and video, that is the option. I'm actually going to have Abel join me for this. So I'm going to invite him as a guest, and he'll get an invite as soon as I set that up. So I've got all my settings, I'm ready to go. I'm going to click create show. Once the show is created, I'm going to double check I'm happy with all the settings. Then I'm going to get the audience link here, I'm going to copy that, and then I'm going to put it in my landing page. I'm going to send this out to people who I want to join as my audience. This link will be riverside.fm/studio/the name of your event. Once I've done that, I'm ready to go into my studio to start recording. So I'm going to click go to recording studio here. I'm going to make sure I'm happy with my settings. I'm going to turn my camera off because it's just going to be an audio only show here. I'm not using headphones. Join the studio. And now you can see my audio session is now ready to go. Before you go live with your show, this is what your viewers will see. In order to go live, you need to click start recording. So go ahead and click that. It will do its countdown and then you'll go live. And now my show is live. To emulate that engagement that you have with Clubhouse of having people dial in, you can do that using the Riverside live stream. As an audience member here, I can see there's a start live calling button. If I'm an audience member that wants to call in, I'll click this. I'll turn my mic on. I'll make sure my camera is off. I'll press continue. I'm going to put my name in, James, and my question. This means there's a little barrier for anyone who wants to call in, so you as the host knows what that person wants to ask or wants to discuss, so you're not accepting just random people onto the call. Click start live call, and then it will start calling. You can see here with this nice animation. If I go back to the host side, you can see here that James is calling in with the following question: what's the best podcast recording software? And I can either choose to decline or bring him in. So I'm gonna click the green button and enable James to come in. One thing to note, if you'd like the recording to work, you need to be on Chrome. So you can see here, I've got 2 different Chrome browsers open, so the recording works seamlessly. Once your guest is in, it's just normal. You can have your conversation. This will be live streamed and also be recorded and captured if you want to use it later. One thing Riverside has that I haven't seen on Clubhouse is a chat function. So you can put in chats and have chats with your guests and with the audience members just through this chat window. It's just an extra way to have some engagement with your audience in your Clubhouse style event. Going back to the host view, I can either stop recording, I can remove James from the call here, I can disconnect him here. Then if I need to, just click stop recording. And now the live will have stopped and it'll upload the recordings from that entire session. From here, you can download your files, turn them into a really nice edit to either put on YouTube or send to your subscribers later. Watch the video in the top right corner to see how we edit our podcast here at Riverside. So that's it. You now have your very own Clubhouse-style live show. Set up your show in riverside.fm, make sure it's an open session, enable live call-ins and go live. That's all there is to it. A question for you. Do you use Clubhouse at the moment? If so, how are you finding it? What do you think? We like it, but if you really want to grow your audience, using a platform like riverside.fm can be a fantastic option for you. We're going to be producing a bunch more videos on this YouTube channel about podcasting, video interviews, and more. So if you want to learn more about starting and growing a podcast, make sure you subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss an episode. Thanks for watching.